Good morning, kids. Today we are going to study environmental studies looking around. Welcome to the science class. We are doing chapter number 5, seeds and seeds. We had already covered some topics of the chapter in previous part of the video. Today we are going to continue with it. Before starting with today's topic, let us quickly revise what we had done in previous part. We had learned about sprouting. Sprouting means to begin to grow. In other words, it is first steps of germination. It is possible only if seeds get enough air and water. We also learned about the process of germination. The seeds germinate to produce a seedling. The seedling absorbs water and nutrients from the soil. Firstly, a tiny root starts growing downwards. Then, upper part of the plant starts growing upward. Soon, baby plant grows with green plant and changes into adult plant. Next important topic we covered was pitcher plant. Pitcher plant is an insectivorous plant. It eats frogs, mice and insects. It is found in Australia, Indonesia and Meghalaya in India. It has special smell that attracts the insects, and as soon as insects land on its mouth, it gets trapped. Now kids, I will not tell you what is our next topic. That you have to guess with the help of this video.
ICE के डायरेक्टर का नाम डॉक्टर वीरू सहस्त्रबुद्धे था, पर सब उन्हें वायरस, कंप्यूटर वायरस बुलाते थे।
अरे वायरस आ रहा है, अंडे लेके, फर्स्ट टीयर को नीचे बुलाया है, जल्दी आओ, जल्दी आओ, जल्दी आओ।
वायरस वाज़ द मोस्ट कॉम्पिटिटिव मैन वी हैड एवर सीन। कोई उनसे एक कदम भी आगे निकल जाए, उनसे बर्दाश्त नहीं होता था। टाइम बचाने के लिए शर्ट पे बटन नहीं, वेलक्रो लगाते थे। और
Okay, now can you guess what is our next topic? Yes, it is Velcro. The principal was using Velcro in his shirt instead of buttons. Okay, what is Velcro? Velcro is a fastener consisting of two strips, one with loops and other with hooks. And that are used to stick two things together. Let us see how Velcro was invented. This happened in 1948. One day, George Mestrel came back from a walk with his dog. He was amazed to find seeds sticking all over his clothes and on his dog's fur. He wondered what made them stick. So he observed these seeds under a microscope. He saw that seeds had many tiny hooks which got stuck to clothes or fur. This gave Mestrel the idea of making Velcro. He made a material with similar tiny hooks that would stick. Velcro is used to stick together many things. Clothes, shoes, bags, bells, and many more. What a way to take inspiration from nature. So who invented Velcro? Yes, it was George Mestrel. But how? That we are going to see in this video.
Who invented Velcro brand fasteners? In 1941, Swiss engineer George de Mistral goes hiking in the woods with his dog. It's all very pleasant until George notices the prickly seeds that are sticking to his clothes and his dog. At home, George puts a burdock burr under a microscope. He finds it's covered in tiny hooks that attach to clothes and fur. He says. 8 years of research later, George has invented the hook and loop fastener, which he then branded Velcro. Tiny hooks on one strip of nylon attached to loops on the other. It's a zipperless zipper, he says. But not everyone is impressed. Hook and loop gets its big break when it's used by NASA astronauts in the 1960s. Even more impressive, in the 1980s, David Letterman jumps onto a wall wearing a hook and loop suit. Today, it's used in everything from luggage to medicine. So when you hear that rip, think of George and his dog.
Okay, now it must be clear to you how Velcro was invented. But where do we use Velcro? Actually, Velcro is found almost everywhere. In our shoes, in our wrist watches, in our belts, in our bags, in our laptop chargers, and many more places. Can you find out 5 things more in which you see Velcro? Pen them down and share it with your teacher. Okay, our next topic is dispersal of seeds. Dispersal of seeds means movement of seeds from one place to another. There are certain agents that are responsible for their movement. Let us see some factors, some causes, some agents of dispersal of seeds one by one. First one is water. Seeds of plants that grow near water bodies are easily carried by water. For example, coconut and lily. Next agent is by wind. Some seeds are very light, so they are blown by the air. For example, dandelion, which you can see in front of you. And one more example is cotton. You know that how light cotton is, right? Next agent of dispersal of seed is animals. As we have seen, in case of George Mistral, some seeds have hooks or spine which stick to your body of animals. Even they eat fruits and throw the seeds here and there. For example, mango or apple. Another important agent of dispersal is bursting. Some seeds become dry and explode. For example, pea pod and castor. Another important agent of dispersal is by travelers. When human beings eat juicy and fleshy fruits like watermelon, apple, melon, mango, etc., they throw the seeds here and there and become the factor of dispersal of seeds. Okay, let us see some seeds that came from different countries long time ago. Have you included human beings also in your list? Yes, we also carry seeds from one place to another, knowingly or unknowingly. We bring the seeds of plants that we find beautiful or useful to grow them with our garden. Later, the seeds of these plants spread to other places. Many years later, people may not even remember that these plants did not grow here earlier. They were bought from somewhere else. Do you know from where chilies came to our country? These were brought to India by traders coming from South America. Today, we cannot think of food without chilies. Yes, we are going to see some more examples of the seeds that came from different countries. For example, from South America, we bought tomato, potato, and green chili. From Europe, we bought cabbage, pea. From Africa, we bought coffee beans, green bhindi. And India exported mangoes, orange, methi, etc. Now kids, it's time to refer dictionary. Are you ready? First word that we learned was dispersal. Act of scattering from one place to another is called dispersal. Second word is germination. That is germination. Growth of baby plant from a seed is called germination. Next word was bursting. Bursting. Process of explosion is called bursting. Next word is overflow. Flow over the container is called overflow. Next word we learned was reproduction. The process through which all living beings produce their own kind is called reproduction. Next word is seed coat. The thick covering of a seed is called seed coat. So kids, I hope this chapter is clear to you. Thank you.